Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to worship here on what we are celebrating as Epiphany Sunday today. A couple announcements before we get started. We are having Sunday school starting on the second Sunday of every month. So January 9th will be the first one, and it'll be during fellowship time, so at about 10 o'clock or thereabouts. So it's open for kids in preschool through as far up as preschool and up is what I've been told. And so have your kids come. Please join us for that time of singing and crafting and story time. Also, as you can see out in the fellowship hall, there are various books that are out there laying around. And so it's a free will offering sale for the month of January, and all the proceeds will go to our library here in Belgrade. We invite you to join us for that. I think those are the main announcements. Jam begins also on January 5th. If you have kids that were not signed up before, we invite them to join us on January 5th. Those are all the announcements I have for today. Does anybody have anything they'd like to add?
This is a pre-plan, but we should thank you for all your donations that we collected for Place of Hope. Mary and I took them over to St. Cloud along with some quilts from New Day, and we had half of her van full anyway of stuff, and that's wonderful. And now the baskets are full again, so I really want to thank you for all your donations for that. All the New Day ladies are working on the quilts, but that's really nice. And I know Darlene's going to take the socks, or somebody is, for the veterans, and those baskets are full, so... you guys have been very, very generous. Oh, and I want to thank Lois and Evie. They took quilts to Lutheran World Relief, right? Yeah, and that was 58 quilts we took from 2 days. So thank you. We should have done that a little earlier, but
thank you, Darlene. Please stand as you are able as we begin worship this morning. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God who was in the beginning, who makes a dwelling among us, who covers us with justice and mercy. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. God of goodness and loving kindness, we confess that we have sinned against you and our neighbors. We have turned away from your invitation to new life. We have turned away from the lowly and downtrodden. In your abundant mercy, forgive us our sins, those we know and those known only to you, for the sake of the one who came to live among us, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Hear the good news of peace and salvation. God forgives us all our sins, not through our own work, but through Jesus Christ, made known to all people. With all who come to the manger, rejoice in the amazing gift of grace. Amen. Our opening hymn this morning is number 300, The First Noel.
Thank you.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, on this day you revealed your Son to the nations by the leading of a star. Lead us now by faith to know your presence on our lives, and bring us at last to the full version of your glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our hymn of praise this morning is This Little Light of Mine, number 677.
May he be like rain that falls on May all kings fall down before him. All nations give him service.
For he delivers the meek even in all, the poor and those who have no helper.
He has pity on the weak and the needy, and saves the lives of the needy.
From oppression and violence, he redeems their life, and precious their blood in his sight.
The second lesson is from Ephesians chapter 3, verses 1 through 12. This is the reason that I call him a prisoner for Christ Jesus, for the sake of you Gentiles. For surely you have already heard of the commission of God's grace that was given me for you, and how the mystery was made known to me by revelation, as I wrote above in a few words, a reading of which will enable you to perceive my understanding of the mystery of Christ. In former generations, this mystery was not made known to humankind, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. That is, the Gentiles have become fellow heirs, members of the same body, and sharers in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. Of this gospel, I have become a servant, according to the gift of God's grace that was given me by the working in his power. Although I am the very least of all the saints, this grace was given to me to bring to the Gentiles the news of the boundless riches of Christ, and to make everyone see what is the plan and the mystery hidden for ages in God who created all things, so that through the church, the wisdom of God and its rich variety might now be made known to the rulers and authorities in the heavenly places. This was in accordance with the eternal purpose that he has carried out in Christ Jesus, our Lord, in whom we have access to God in boldness and confidence through faith in him. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
I invite any kids to come forward for the children's message. And they kissed his little cheek and they said, "Sleep well, little one." and they left him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. Those were very expensive gifts, and they were gifts fit for a king. Later, the wise men decided it was time to go home, and they were planning to tell King Herod where they found baby Jesus, but God sent an angel to talk to them in a dream, and the angel told them that King Herod was dangerous, so they went home a different way instead. Jesus was indeed a new baby king who surprised the wise men and frightened King Herod. Jesus was God's promise, born for us, a gift to all people. That's our story for today. Those three wise men, they followed that star and found Jesus, who was born, right, of Mary and of Joseph. So the wise men found him, and they knew that King Herod wasn't even very nice. And so instead of helping him out, he went and he went another way for him so that it helped them protect baby Jesus, right? And did you guys all have good Christmas? You did? Did you also bring some presents? Did you get some presents? You did? So those three wise men. So the presents that the wise men, they brought some very important presents to Jesus too. So that's something we can remember, that we can give presents to other people and we can give presents ourselves. So those are what the wise men did. That's the story of the day. You guys pray with me? Good and gracious God, Lord, I give you thanks for these kids. Lord, bless them just like we bless those wise men with the gift of Jesus. Lord, we love you and we praise you. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Please stand as you are able as we sing a gospel acclamation. January 6th. Now today is only January 2nd, But I like to talk about Epiphany always on the first Sunday of January. So this is what you get for today, right? So what is Epiphany? Epiphany is a church holiday that recognizes the very first time that Jesus interacts with non-Jewish people, also known as Gentiles. Granted, Jesus is only a baby at the time, but this encounter is important to Gentiles as it symbolizes that Jesus is for all people, not just those of Jewish descent. The non-Jewish people who first encounter Jesus are what we call three wise men. They're also called magi, right? And these three wise men, they traveled from a distant land, often believed to be Persia, to greet this newborn king and to bring him gifts, right? Gifts that were fit for a king, of gold, of frankincense, and myrrh. Very, very expensive gifts. And the wise men, they were known as astrologers, which were people who were experts in their knowledge about stars. And so these wise men, they traveled from that distant eastern land, following that star of David in search of this newborn king. Now think of that, astrologers or wise men or magi following a star to see something. Think of the faith that it took to travel such a long way. It wasn't like they could jump on a plane and be there in a few hours. Or it wasn't like they had an automobile that had not been invented yet. It's not like they could get in a car and they could drive all night. In biblical times, traveling was challenging and it was exhausting and it took a very long time. And these wise men, they encountered also some dangerous people and places on that journey. You heard about it in today's children's sermon. One of those dangerous places and people was Herod, who was found in Jerusalem. The wise men, they arrived in Jerusalem, and they asked the people there, "Where is this child who's been born of the King of the Jews? For we observed his star is rising, and we've come to pay him homage." Now King Herod, he got really nervous when his chief priests and scribes pointed out that this had been prophesied long ago by a prophet. Herod was known in the ancient world for both his paranoia and his brutality. Not really things to be known for, right? His paranoia and his brutality. And history tells us that Herod had one of his wives and several of his sons murdered because he thought they were plotting against him. Again, a sign of paranoia. The wise men coming to Jerusalem and asking about the newborn king, that really activated Herod's paranoia. As a result, Herod started asking the wise men for details on when and where they saw this star. Herod asked the wise men to send in word when they found this baby, so that Herod could come and also pay him homage. Now Herod was not wanting to bring Jesus' family a shower gift in celebration of the birth of Jesus, but rather Herod was paranoid that Jesus would become king. And Herod did not want to lose his reign on the kingdom. And so Herod used his power and his influence to hurt a whole lot of people. Herod was hoping to kill all male babies who were born within 2 years of the wise men seeing the star of David. Herod used his power and influence not for good, but for evil. And Herod caused countless families to suffer because their newborn sons were killed. This is an example that power can be used for good and it can also be used for evil. In this case, Herod used his power for evil. We know that Jesus did not come to this earth so that he could be a king like Herod. But rather, Jesus came to be a leader who taught about truth and justice and love and grace and forgiveness. In a sense, Jesus was really the polar opposite of Herod. The two were not competing, but Herod, he didn't really seem to know that. He was only worried about himself and his kingdom and his power. Jesus and Herod really were polar opposites. Jesus came from humble beginnings, born in a manger. Herod, he was from the wealthy. Herod also took the life of others, and Jesus came from humble beginnings, Jesus would go on to be a king and a leader who would not take life, but rather would give life. This story reminds us again that Jesus is the Savior of the world, who came as a baby, who dwelt among us, who shined his light bright for all the world. This story teaches us again that Jesus is our King, and we should put him first in our lives. Now those wise men, if you think about them, they chose Jesus over Herod. They could have colluded with him, but instead they bought the newborn king gifts fit for a king, those of gold and frankincense and myrrh. For the wise men, Jesus was greater and more powerful than Herod. They had endured a long journey from Persia in the east to Bethlehem to meet this child, this king. They risked their lives for the sake of Jesus. They rejoiced when they met him. In the book of Matthew, we learn that the wise men paid homage to Jesus and not to Herod. Herod was a powerful man, but instead of following for his deceitful ways, these wise men, they left a different way than they had come. The wise men, these astrologers, these non-Jewish people, they knew and they respected and they cherished and they worshiped Jesus. They were the ones who put Jesus first in their lives. I think that begs the question for us here today. Are we willing to put Jesus first in our lives? Do we put Jesus first in our lives? As we begin a new year, as we begin anew, we have a new chance to set new intentions in a new year. A question to reflect on may be this one. Do I put Jesus first in my life? How can I turn my focus away from the things of this world and toward the things from above? I think it's a personal question that requires one to think and ponder and pray. So I invite you to think and ponder to pray on this question. This question of whether you are willing and you do put Jesus first in your life. And all God's people said, amen. Our hymn of the day today is What Child Is This? Number 296. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. I invite you to take out your bulletin insert. On the back of our insert are our prayer list, and we will be naming aloud the first name of those on our prayer list. Joining our voices with the heavenly host and Christians throughout time and space, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. God of wonders, you sent the Magi from afar to witness the mystery and majesty of your birth. Send us into the world with your will in our hearts and on our lips. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O God, you created the heaven and the earth. Through your Spirit, send your all-encompassing love over the cosmos. Bless the stars that guide our way and the night sky that invites the earth into slumber. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O God, you sent the Magi to follow the star into an uncertain future. May all leaders and people seek your face, especially when paths are not clear. Conflicts rage, tyrants oppress, and fear abounds. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O God, you sent your Spirit to dwell with Paul, who was in prison. Send your Spirit to those who are imprisoned and enslaved. Give courage and wisdom for building roads that lead to justice and freedom. Lord, we lift up to you now those who are on our prayer list. The Lindsay family. Ruth, Kelly, Richard, Gail, Marilyn, Eugene, Vicki, Rudine, Sid, Dwayne, Janet, Helen, and all those that we now name in our hearts, having the confidence that through the power of the Holy Spirit, God knows our needs. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O God, you sent the Holy Family to seek safety in a new land. Protect all who make similar journeys, sending your guiding spirit to asylum seekers, refugees, and all who journey toward safety. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Rejoicing in your word made flesh among us, we commend these prayers to you, confident of your grace and love made known to us in Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. May the peace of Christ be with you always. Let us share a sign of peace with those around us. Grab one of the stars. That might take a while to get around, but you will get one. There are plenty. So in the meantime, we are not still passing the plate for offering, but the offering plate is located in the back of the sanctuary. We're thankful for your generosity and support of Grace Lutheran Church. And as a way of giving thanks for our offerings, we will sing our offertory hymn, "We Are an Offering."
I invite our communion server to come forward.
Please stand as you are able. Now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. We thank you, wondrous God, for Jesus, God with us, in these gifts of bread and wine. As we have shared this feast of love, strengthen us to share your love with all the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now receive this blessing. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing, so that we may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit, through Christ Jesus, for whom we wait. Amen. Our closing hymn this morning will be number 671, Shine, Jesus, Shine.